Welcome back to a new video, and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can protect your API keys so that no one can access it very easily. So let's see how you can do it. So for that you need a project, so just create a project for yourself. And if you want my project, you can go to my GitHub repository, link present in the description box. Okay, so here first I'm gonna change my mode from Android to project, and in this root level I'm gonna create a file, and the file name is secret.properties. By the way, I'm using here properties file in order to protect my API key information. In this, we have our API keys. So just use some gibberish key. This is for the debug. For prod, I'm using here API key prod. And yeah, so we have here two different keys. One is for the debug environment. Second one is actually used for our production. So let's see how we can use these two information. Now, in order to use these two information, we have to create build config fields. So let's see how we can do it. Go to your module app level build gradle.kts, and in the Android closer, just above your build field types, I'm going to create a variable, and the variable name is local properties. This is an object of our properties class. So use your properties, import it. Make sure this is coming from java.util. Okay, so now we have local properties. Now it's time to use my secret.properties file. So for that, I'm using your local properties file. This is a file, so use your file. First, we have to give the path information. I mean, where do you put this information? So in my case, I'm using my root directory because secret.properties is present in this root directory. Next, we have to pass the name, which is secret.properties. Alright, so now it's time to check whether this file exists or not. So local property.file exists. So if it exists and local.properties file is actually a file, then only we will proceed. Now it's time to read all of the information from secret.properties. Well, it's very easy. Use local properties file. Open an input stream, use here a use function, and in its lambda, I'm gonna load all of my information to my local properties. So local properties.load, simply pass your reader. Now we have all the information which is coming from secret.properties present in our local properties. Now it's time to use it. So in our build type, we have here release. Now I'm gonna create one more product flavor, which is debug. Now in this, I'm gonna create few build config field. So for that, use your build config field. First, you have to pass the type. So my type is string. Next, the name. So name is API key. By the way, you can give the name whatever you want. In my use case, I'm using a simple API keys. Now, lastly, we have to put the value of this variable. So how can we do it? Well, for that, I'm using my local properties dot get properties. And in this, we have to pass our key. So in our secret properties, if you look for the debug one, I'm using my API key. So go to your build gradle KTS, and in place of key, simply pass it. All right. So this is for the debug one. Next, copy this information, put in your release product flavor. Now in this case, I'm using your prod one. Basically, we have two different API keys, like API key for the debug one, API key for the production. So now we have two different build config field. One is for the production. Second one is for the debug environment. All right, so we are pretty much done in here. Now it's time to sync our project so that it will generate everything. Okay, so syncing is completed. Now open up your source, main, Java, main activity. And in this main activity, in place of name, I'm using my build config field. So build config, and in this we have API underscore key. Okay, so now I'm gonna clean this project and rebuild it. All right, so we have a problem here. Build type debug contains custom build config fields, but the feature is disabled. So we have to enable this feature. So go to your buildgradle.kts, and in this we have build features at the bottom. Now use here simply build config to true. So what it will do, it will simply enable the custom fields. Sync your project. All right, so if you want to use rest values, Then on that case, you have to enable the thing too. Simply use rest values equal true and sync your project. Okay, so go to main activity, and this time we have our API key. Now go to this API key. This is our information that we have put in secret.properties over here. Alright, so now it's time to execute and see whether this information is coming properly or not. Okay, so here we have information. Hello, something, something, something. I mean the API key. Okay, so we are done with this API key. Now it's time to protect those API key. How can we do it? So if you want to protect this information, what you can do, you can simply remove the secret.properties from your Git tracking system and add this file into your Git ignore. So let's do it. So here go to Git ignore and put your secret.properties. So what it will do, it will not push secret.properties file into the GitHub repository. But for that, open up your terminal, and in this terminal, first we have to remove this secret.properties file from our Git tracking system. So use here git rm dash dash cached secret.properties. Enter. So I haven't added secret.properties file in our Git tracking system till now. If you have already did this thing, what you can do, you can simply remove that information from your Git tracking system and push your code to the GitHub. So let's push this code in our GitHub and see whether this secret.properties is present in our GitHub repository or not. So for that, I'm going to create one more branch, and this time I'm going to call this final code. Now create a branch. Okay, simply use Control K. So these are the changes. Okay, so I'm going to push everything, and this time I'm going to call this final commit instead of initial commit. Commit and push. Okay, so these are the files. Push it. Okay, so now let's see whether this file is present in our GitHub repository or not. So for that, open up your Chrome. This is my GitHub repository. Let's refresh it. We have here final code somewhere over here. Let me just refresh it. So here you can see we are not getting secret.properties file because we have added that thing in our Git ignore over here. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you like this video. It's a very simple video, but at the same time, it will increase the protection of your API key. And if you want to share this information to your fellow developers, you can simply put the secret.properties file at a secure location so that your fellow developer can access it. And once they receive the code, they can simply put secret.properties file manually in their project. So yeah, this is approach that we'll use. I hope you enjoyed a lot. Goodbye.